Hello everybody, today we all have gathered over here to talk about one of the prestigious examination, that is NEET 2019. So this NEET examination, we all know that is a gateway for MBBS. So first of all, in this session I'll be talking about the paper analysis and then I'll be talking about the solutions for various questions. First of all, let me give you analysis for this examination, which was held on 5th of May, yesterday. The whole paper, that was quite easy, and if I have to rate it, whether it was difficult, easy or moderate, I would rather say it is a very easy to moderate type of paper. The reason was 70% of the questions, they were directly from the NCRT. So those who have gone through the whole chapter from the NCRT, I'm 100% sure they would be having a smile on their faces. Similarly, it was a win-win situation for me as well, because recently we conducted a crash course and 10-11 questions, they were directly from our crash course, right? And one more thing, as per the botany, zoology, as per your biology was considered, the paper was very easy, easy to moderate type. So direct questions were there. Now to talk about the chemistry was also easy, but physics was a bit difficult, right? So let's talk about the question. So I'll be dealing with the code S6 and we'll start with the first question of biology. So this is question number 46 of the code S6, right? So question indicate what is the site of perception of photoperiod necessary for induction of flowering in plants. So this question is related to the photoperiodism, and in this case when we talk about the induction happens in case of leaves, because they have a presence of the photopigments with them. So hope you remember that PFR and the PR, that are interconvertible forms, and that leads to the flowering in the long day plant and the short day plant depending upon the concentration in which they are present, right? So as per the question 46 is considered, the correct answer we have is option 2, that is leaves, right? So this was also a direct question from NCRT. Let's move on to the next question, question number 47. Now this question, as we always discuss, that these type of questions related to the hormones, related to a disease, they are one of the favorite questions and they are frequently asked in an exam. Now match the following hormones with the respective disease. On one side they have mentioned the hormones, on the second side they have mentioned the certain diseases. Now we have to match it. A, insulin. We all know about the insulin. So insulin, what it does, it regulates the glucose level in blood. So those person on which the insulin is not, their insulin is not producing in appropriate quantity, they definitely suffer from the diabetes mellitus. So for the A, the correct option we have is fifth, right? Now B indicate thyroxine. Yes, thyroxine, that means I'm talking about the thyroid gland. For the B, the correct option we have is goiter, right, in which swelling of these thyroid glands occur. Now the corticoids, you know, we are talking about the adrenal cortex, and the disease which is associated with the corticoids is the Addison disease, right? Next is a growth hormone. We all know about the growth hormone. The excess production during the childhood, because this growth hormone, this is produced by hypothalamus and that is stored in the posterior part of the pituitary. So it leads to the acromegaly, right? So for the A, the correct option we have is fifth, then we have is a fourth, then we have is the first one. So I'll go for an option A, right? We have to choose a correct option, right? Now let's move on to the next question, question number 48. Now again, this was very easy question from animal physiology. Use of an artificial kidney during hemodialysis may result in, right? So we are talking about an artificial kidney, a mechanism of a dialysis. That is a last topic of the chapter. So A, the nitrogenous waste build up in the body. We are using an artificial kidney. That means basically what is the function of kidney? To excrete these nitrogenous waste. And if we are using this hemodialysis, if we are going through the dialysis procedure, this is quite obvious that they will be removed. So this was you can say they will not build up. So this was an incorrect option. B, non-elimination of the excess potassium ion, no. In fact, they will also be eliminated. Next is a reduced absorption of the calcium ion from the gastrointestinal tract. Is it right or wrong? This is absolutely right. Now, reduced absorption of the calcium ion from the gastrointestinal tract. Because what actually happens is vitamin D is converted into calcitrol with the help of the kidney, right? And this calcitrol help in the reabsorption of the calcium ion. So this one is correct. Now let's look at the D option. Reduced RBC production, yes, because the function of you can say this kidney is also the erythropoiesis mechanism. So which option is the most appropriate? The most appropriate option among these all the four options is the C and D. So which option is right? I'll go for an option A in this. Right? Now let's move on to the next question. Question number 49. Now, which of the following ecological pyramids is generally inverted? So inverted pyramids, hope you remember, in which the broader, like upper part is a broader as compared to a lower part. So first indicate the pyramid of biomass in a forest. So pyramid of biomass in a forest is always upright. We know this, right? Because there are certain plants are there, they are fed upon by the organism present at the next trophic level. And the plants in the, you can say these green plants, they are having a higher biomass as compared to the organism present at the herbivore level or the carnivore level. So this is upright. So this one is upright. Right. Now, pyramid of biomass in a sea. So, pyramid of biomass is in a sea is always inverted. And they were asking the inverted type, so I'll go for an option 2. Now, listen very carefully. Inverted type of pyramid, that means the whole base is like this. This is upper part, organism present at the higher trophic level. Then we have organism like this, the organism present at the various trophic level. This we call it as an inverted. Now listen very carefully, this is a first trophic level, and in case of the first trophic level, organisms such as you can say phytoplanktons, they are present. As per the biomass is considered, the phytoplanktons, they are having a less biomass as compared to zooplanktons. So zooplanktons, suppose these are the phytoplanktons, phyto, then we have is a zooplankton, then we have is a small fishes. Then we have is large fishes. So, who would be having a more biomass, a highest biomass? It is quite obvious that large fishes will be having a highest biomass. So, this pyramid is always inverted, and they are asking for inverted pyramids only. Now, the second option is correct. Let's look at the option 3. Pyramid of number in a grassland. So, pyramid of number in a grassland, that is also upright. So, number means to say those organisms such as the plants, they are higher in number as compared to the those organisms which are present at the higher trophic level such as the herbivore, the carnivore, they are comparatively less, which we know. So, this is also upright. Now, the pyramid of energy. So, without any exception, the pyramid of energy is always upright. Why? Because energy decreases from one trophic level to another. Right? So, this was also a direct question. 49, correct option B. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 50. So, question from the reproductive health. Now, select the hormone releasing intrauterine devices. So, the four options which are given are progestacert, LNG20, lipase loop, multi-load 375 volts, the multi-load progestacert. So, in this case, which option is correct? I'll go for an option first, progestacert. So these are the hormone releasing intrauterine devices, right? Let's move on to the next question, question number 51. Now again, this is a very important, if I say, and like direct question from the NCRT. Okay, let me tell you one thing. Respiratory quotient value of the tripalmitin is direct question from the NCRT, and in this case, if you remember, when this respiratory quotient is mentioned, there they have in the bracket of facts, they have mentioned the tripalmitin, right? So, for the tripalmitin, the correct option, that is a 0.7, the RQ value, right? The amount of carbon dioxide that is evolved to that of the oxygen which is used, that we call it as a RQ value, right? So, this was also a direct question, very easy as well. Let's move on to the next question, question number 52. Which of the following statement regarding the mitochondria is incorrect. Regarding the mitochondria is incorrect. Right? Now, inner membrane is convoluted with foldings. Yes, the inner membranes, they have cristae present in them, which are the infolding, which increases the overall surface area so that the more electron transport can happen. Second, mitochondrial matrix contain a single circular DNA molecule and the ribosome. Yes, mitochondria, they have their own genome. That is why they are considered as a semi-autonomous organelle. Right? So, this one is also correct and this one is also correct. And we are looking for an incorrect option. Let's look at the C. Outer membrane is permeable to monomer of carbohydrates, fats and protein. Yes. The outer membrane as compared to inner membrane, that is more permeable, and this we have studied. So, this is also correct. Let's look at the D option. Enzymes of electron transport chain are embedded in outer membrane. Is it right or wrong? This is incorrect, because the enzyme for the ETC, they are located not in outer membrane, rather than they are located in the inner membrane. Right? And we are looking for an incorrect option. So, which option is correct for this? The option 4. Right? Now, let's move on to the next question. Question number 53. Which of the following can be used as a biocontrol agent in the treatment of the plant disease? So, the four options which are given are Anabina, Lactobacillus, the Trichoderma and the Chlorella. Which one is the right option? The Trichoderma is a correct option, which is used to cure, or which is actually inhibit those soil borne diseases which may can happen because of the fungus. Right? So, which one is the correct option? The C, Trichoderma. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 54. Now, the xylem translocate. We know about the xylem. Xylem help in the translocation of the water. Right? And this is that question in which most of the students, they must be wrong, because like they know that they must have gone for the option the water and the mineral salts only. But actually, to talk about this, the minerals, water, salt and some organic nitrogen and a hormone, they are also transported with the help of the xylem. Right? So, which option is correct for this? The second one. Right? Because when we talk about, like in the chapter, this you can say the translocation, the transport in case of plants. In that, we have discussed that along with the water, along with the ions, they also help in the translocation of these substances like organic nitrogen and hormones. Right? So, second option is right for this question 54. Let's move on to the next question, question number 55. Now, which one of the following equipment is essentially required for growing microbes in a large scale for the industrial production of enzyme? See, for the industrial production, what we want is a huge culture. And we have to provide those biotic, or you can say those environment which sustain a large number of population, in which the culture medium should be there, the proper aeration should be possible, we should maintain a proper pH as well. So, everything, all these conditions we have to provide. Right? So, first option is given as an industrial oven, second is a bioreactor, third option is a BOD incubator, and the fourth is a sludge digester. See, basically we go for a fermenter and the bioreactor. So, what is the difference between a fermenter and a bioreactor? In case of the fermenter, we go for some anaerobic reactions. In case of the bioreactor, we go for the aerobic as well as anaerobic, where we culture the cells or any microbes at a huge level by providing them a large number of nutrients and a culture medium, the temperature, we provide optimum temperature also, we keep a particular pH as well. So, which option is right? The second option, that is a bioreactor. Now, let's move on to the next question, question number 56. A gene locus has two alleles, capital A and small a. If the frequency of a dominant allele A is 0.4, now listen very carefully. They are saying frequency of dominant allele, that is for the capital A, it is 0.4, right? Now, they are asking, suppose, for the dominant A, it is 0.4. What will be the frequency of the another allele, that is a small a? that will be 0.6, obviously. Right? This question is from Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. Now, what will be the frequency of a homozygous dominant, heterozygous and homozygous recessive? First of all, let's talk about homozygous dominant. Right? This is a value for P. This is a value for Q. And we know when we have to talk about, when we are talking about a homozygous dominant, how we can calculate the frequency? That by P square. So, 0.4 whole square, that will come out to be 0.16. Right? Now, we have to talk about the heterozygous. So, for the heterozygous, So, how can we calculate for the heterozygous? That is by the formula 2PQ. Very easy this question was, right? Very, very, very easy if I say. So, 2 into 0.4 into 0.6, right? What will be the answer? It will come out to be 0.48, right? Now, next for the homozygous recessive, I'm not going into depth, right? So for that, that will be Q square. So it will come out to be 0.6 into 0.6. That will be 0.36. Right? So for one, it is 0.16, 0.48 and 0.36. Now come back to the question again. 0.16, 0.48 and 0.36. So option A is correct for the question 56. Again, a very easy and a very direct question, right? Let's move on to the next question, question number 57. Now, this question is also direct from the NCERT, and this is in the topic, the fingerprinting, right? And this line is exactly mentioned in your NCERT. EST or the expressed sequence tag refers to, so these are what? Gene which are expressed as RNA, right? So, this was option 3 for the question 57. Hope this question is also right. Now, question number 58. Which of the following STD is not completely curable? So, among all these four options, there is one disease which is not at all curable, and option is herpes, the genital herpes. Next option, the chlamydiasis, gonorrhea and the genital warts, the genital herpes, that is not at all curable, right? Let's move on to the next question, question number 59. This time many questions was from the chapter, you can say, the microbes as well as from the cell as a unit of life. Many questions they were asked from this chapter. DNA precipitation out of the mixture of the biomolecules can be achieved by the treatment of, again a direct question. So in this case the correct option we have is chilled ethanol. So, chilled ethanol is used for the process of isolation. And this is the part of, this is from the chapter, the biotechnology principle and processes. Where the first step itself is the isolation of DNA. And second, we use the restriction enzyme. So, in that we have studied that chilled ethanol is used that actually help in the precipitation process. So, that the DNA they can precipitate. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 6060. This is from the chapter Human Health and Diseases. Which of the following immune response is responsible for the rejection of kidney graft? So, this is also a direct question for the kidney graft. Suppose one has gone through the kidney transplantation. It is quite obvious if rejection occurs. The main immune system which is responsible is a cell mediated immune response. Though somewhere other humoral immune response, this is also responsible for the graft rejection, but primarily this is because of the cell mediated immune response. Where the T cells, they just kill them, do those kills graft, right? So this was the option 2 for the question 60. Now let's move on to the next question, question number 61. This question is from the chapter Evolution. Variation caused by mutation as proposed by Hugo de Vries are. Now the variations, they are what? These are the random changes which happens. So do they have any kind of direction or they are directionless? They are random as well as they are directionless. Any changes which occur, that we call it as a mutation. So mutation, they can be beneficial as well as they cannot be beneficial for us, right? So they are random and they are directionless. So this was also the simple question or very easy. Let's move on to the next question, question number 62. Now, which of the following statement is not correct? Again, they are asking a not correct statement. The first thing is to underline it, right? Now, the four options which are given are lysosomes are the membrane bound structure. Are they membrane bound or not? Yes, they are single membrane bound structure. Now, this one is correct. We have to look for the incorrect option. The lysosomes are formed by the process of packaging in the endoplasmic reticulum. Are they formed like this? No, not at all. So this option is incorrect. Lysosomes has numerous hydrolytic enzymes. Yes, large number of the hydrolytic enzymes, they are present in them and they help in the apoptosis, which is also called as a programmed cell death. Whenever any cell organelle is there and that is not in a functional condition, that is digested by these enzymes present in the lysosome. And also they have a pH, the acidic pH they have. The pH is very low. So this one is also correct and this one is also correct. As we are looking for an incorrect statement, which option is correct? I'll go for an option B for the question 62. Now, let's move on to the next question, question number 63. So by default, this incorrect is underlined again now. Which of the following statement is incorrect? A, the conidia are produced exogenously and ascospore endogenously. Right or wrong? Absolutely right. Yeast are the filamentous body with long thread-like hyphae. Do they have hyphae? No. They do not have a hyphae present. So this option is incorrect and we are looking for an incorrect statement only. So I'll go for an option B or the two in this case. Morels and the truffles, they are edible delicacies. Claviceps is a source of the many alkaloids and LSD. So both of these options, the third and the fourth option, they are correct. Now let's move on to the next question, question number 64. Now identify the correct pair. So we have to look for a correct pair representing the causative agents of the typhoid fever and the confirmatory test for the typhoid. This question is from the chapter Human Health and Diseases. Now, they are asking the typhoid. So, who causes typhoid? That is caused by the Salmonella typhi. And what is the confirmatory test? Confirmatory test again, the viral test is used. Right? This was again a direct question. Option 2. Now, let's move on to the next question. Question number 65. Now, what is a genetic disorder in which an individual has an overall masculine development, gynecomastia and is sterile? What is gynecomastia? That is a development of breast in males. Now, the four options are given, four different diseases are given, and we have to identify on the basis of the symptom of patient, right? Now, the Edward syndrome. What is the Edward syndrome? So, this Edward syndrome is trisomy of chromosome number 18. Trisomy of chromosome 18. Right. Next, they have mentioned the second option, that is a Down syndrome. This was the Edwards syndrome. Down syndrome. So what is a Down syndrome? Down syndrome is a trisomy of chromosome number 21. Trisomy of chromosome 21. So that means the three copies of this chromosome is present rather than a two copies. Next is a Turner syndrome. So Turner syndrome is what? So these basically occur in case of females, in which one X chromosome is absent. Now next we have is Turner's syndrome. Right? XO type. That means one X chromosome absent. Right. In this case, the female, they have a rudimentary ovary. Next is a Klinefelter syndrome. This is a Klinefelter syndrome. So, what is a Klinefelter syndrome? In this syndrome, the condition is XXY. XXY type. Right? So these occur in case of male, and the male have a one extra X chromosome present. So due to which they are sterile, they have or they suffer from the gynecomastia. So what is the right option for this question? Option is fourth, right? Let's move on to the next question, question number 66. Now, this is from the chapter Body Fluid and Circulation. Match the column 1 and 2. Now the column 1, the P wave. So what is a P wave? How it arises? This arises because of the depolarization of atria. So for this, the depolarization of atria is the right answer. Next is a QRS complex or a QRS wave. How it occurs? Because of the depolarization of ventricles. Because of the depolarization of ventricles. Now the T wave, how does T wave occur? So the T wave because of the repolarization of atria, right? Next is the reduction of, next is a reduction in the T wave. For this, the coronary ischemia is the right answer, right? Hope you can manage or hope you can match this by yourself, and we have to look for a correct option. Now let's move on to the next question, question number 67. Again, which of the following glucose transporter is insulin dependent? GLUT, what is the full form? That is a glucose transporter. So those glucose transporter which are associated with the insulin, or they occur or they help in the transport mechanism because of the insulin, in response to insulin, that is a GLUT4. That is a GLUT4. Option 2 is correct. Right? Let's move on to the next question, question number 68. Identify the cells whose secretion protect the lining of the gastrointestinal tract from various enzymes. See, enzymes are there in stomach, and because acidic pH is also there, the enzymes are also there. So protection of these wall or the mucosa layer, that is also important. How it happens? Because of the presence of the goblet cells. Goblet cells, they secrete mucus. What they does is, they secrete mucus. Right? And the mucus, they help in the protection. Right? So, for this, the correct option we have is fourth. Let's move on to the next question, question number 69. Which one of the following statement regarding the post-fertilization development in flowering plant is incorrect? So we have to again look for an incorrect statement. The four options are given. The first is the central cell develop into an endosperm. So if you remember, those male gamete or that male gamete which enter via synergid, they always fuses with the two polar nuclei present in the central cell. And that lead to the formation of endosperm, and that endosperm is triploid. So this option is also correct, and we are looking for an incorrect one. Now listen very carefully. Ovules develop into embryo sac. See, ovules develop into embryo sac, actually they develop into the seeds, right? And they are talking about a post-fertilization development. This is an incorrect option. Now the ovary develop into the fruit. This is obvious. The true fruits are those in which the ovary, they develop into the fruits. The zygote develop into the embryo, this is also correct. So I'll go for an option 2 for the question 69. Let's move on to the next question, question number 70. Now, Again, a very easy type, very easy type question. The correct sequence of the phases of the cell cycle is, we know that first of all we have is a G1 phase, then we have is a S phase, then the G2 phase, then the M phase, right? So which option is right among these? We'll go for an option 2, G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase and M phase, right? So this was the question 70, let's move on to the next question, question number 71. The concept of omnicellulae, this was regarding the cell division was proposed by. So this was given by Rudolf Virchow. So what do you mean by omnicellulae? That means a cell, they arise from a pre-existing cell. So when a cell is coming, that means it is formed from another cell, another parent cell. So this was given by the Rudolf Virchow. So third option is correct. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 72. Now, what triggers an activation of prototoxin to activate BT toxin of Bacillus thuringiensis in a ball worm? So, this question is from the chapter, the biotechnology application. They are asking the actually this toxin or the prototoxin, this toxin which is produced by the Bacillus thuringiensis, that is actually a prototoxin. So prototoxin, that means that this is an inactive form. And how it is activated? Whenever a ball worm, whenever these worms, they consume it. They consume it, they have a pH or alkaline pH in their gut. That prototoxin is converted into a toxin or an active form. Later on, that toxin causes perforation in the gut, which lead to death of the insect. And this is for the prevention, this is from the prevention or basically to increase the productivity and to make the plant resistant to the different pests belonging to the Coleoptera, belonging to the Dipterans and Lepidoptera, right? So which option is right? I'll go for an option A, right? Let's move on to the next question, question number 73. Concavalin A is a lactin, right? This is a direct question, so option 1 is correct for this question, right? Let's move on to the next question, question number 74. This was that question which was there in our crash course also, one of very important and a very easy question. If you know the diagram of a male reproductive system, you can easily answer this question. So, select the correct sequence of transport of sperm cell in the male reproductive system. See, the sperms, they are produced where? They are produced in the seminiferous tubule. From the seminiferous tubule, once they are produced, they enter into, in this the options which are given, the first seminiferous tubules, the vasa efferentia, then this one is incorrect. Next it is given as a testis, okay, we can say that the testis or the, you can say the seminiferous tubule, this is a broad term testis. Epididymis, then the vasa efferentia, then vas deferens, then again the ejaculatory duct, no, this one is also incorrect. Testis, epididymis, the vas efferentia, rete testis, after that it is coming the rete testis, this one is also incorrect. Seminiferous tubule, rete testis, vasa efferentia, then epididymis, then vas deferens, the ejaculatory duct, urethra and the last one, that is a urethral meatus. So fourth option is correct. So once it is produced, it will enter into the rete testis, which is just near to the testis. Above this, we have is a vasa efferentia. Vasa efferentia carries it to the epididymis. From epididymis, sperms are being transported and it enter into the vas deferens. From vas deferens, along with the, you can say, a urine duct, it forms a common ejaculatory duct from urethra, and from urethra it goes to the outside. So, which option is correct? Option 4 is correct for this question. Let's move on to the next question, question number 75. Now, which of the following statement is correct? Again, the correct one. Cornea is convex transparent layer which is highly vascularized. Cornea is vascularized or not? This is not at all vascularized. In fact, in this, you can say the blood vessels, they are not present. That is the biggest reason behind the survival or biggest reason or basically the graft rejection doesn't occur in this case because they are not at all vascularized if one go for the cornea transplantation. The cornea consists of dense matrix of the collagen, is the most sensitive portion of the eye. Incorrect. The cornea is external, transparent, and the protective proteinaceous covering of the eyeball. Yes, this is a correct one. Next, the cornea consists of the dense connective tissue, elastin, and can repair itself. No, this one is also incorrect. So, which option is right? I'll go for an option 3 for this question. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 76. Now, drug called heroin is synthesized by, how it is synthesized? We know that it is synthesized from the morphine by the process of acetylation. Right? So, this one is also a direct question directly asked from your NCERT. So, that's why I keep on repeating, please focus on your NCERT. In fact, in each and every session, I have discussed that please focus on your NCERT. Whatever coaching notes you have, whatever sessions you are watching, don't forget your NCERT. Whatever important lines you find, whatever things which are there, you should have a thorough knowledge of it. Just underline the things, do not at all forget a single line. Very important your NCERT is. And I am giving this guarantee, I am just like, if you will follow your NCERT, if you will thorough read your NCERT, 70 to 80% of question you can directly attempt for your NEET examination. I am talking about only biology or botany and zoology. So, this was option 4 for the question 76. Let's move on to the next question, question number 77. So, this was a quite tricky question, quite tricky. If I have to judge, I'll say this is a moderate type, not a difficult one. Now, under which of the following condition will there be no change in the reading frame of the following mRNA? So, they have given a sequence and they are saying, suppose some changes we go or we some changes happen in the sequence, what will be the consequence? Now, the A option is given, insertion of A and G at the 4th and the 5th position. So, this one is 4th position. So, at the 4th position over here, we are inserting one A and G. We are inserting two nucleotide at this time. Insertion of two nucleotide will change a reading frame. But in question, they are saying there will should not be a no change. Suppose there will be, or you can say deletion of three nucleotide, there will be no change in the sequence, there will be no reading frame change, though that particular amino acid will not be formed, this is 100% sure, but there will be no shifting of frame. This we call it as a frame shift mutation. So this one is incorrect. Let's look at the second option, deletion of GGU. That means they are talking like three nucleotides are there and three nucleotides they have knocked out. So, that means all these three nucleotides, they will definitely be coding for a one particular amino acid. See, where this GGU is present, 7th, 8th and 9th. Now, listen to this very carefully. So, the first three particular nucleotides, they will code for one amino acid. After that, we have these three nucleotides, they will be coding for a second amino acid. Now, next is a GGU, definitely it will be coding for the third amino acid. If I will knock out all of these three, if I will delete all of these three, it is quite definite that they will not be going to change the reading frame further. So, this option is correct. Now, the insertion of G at the 5th position. So, they are inserting something, they are not deleting. So, insertion is happening, but deletion is not happening. So, there will be one change in the nucleotide, one addition in fact it is happening. So, it is obvious that in this case, there will be change in the reading frame. Deletion of gene, again they are deleting one, so there will be shift in the reading frame. So, I will go for option second in this case. Right? Let's move on to the next question, question number 78. Again, this is a direct question from your NCERT and this question, this topic is from the chapter Biotechnological Applications. So, which one of the following is true for the golden rice? Now, today we have golden rice available and this golden rice has vitamin A, right? Now, the first it is a drought tolerant, golden rice is drought tolerant, no. It has a yellow green because of the gene introduced from a primitive variety of rice. They are yellow in color because they have the beta carotene present. So, it is a vitamin A enriched with gene from the daffodil. This option is correct, right? Now, the fourth, it is a pest resistant, no, this is not at all pest resistant. Now, let's move on to the next question, question number 79. The ciliated epithelium cells are required to move the particles or the mucus in a specific direction. In humans, these cells are mainly presented. Now, they are talking about a ciliated mechanism or ciliated epithelium is there, right? Now, this ciliated epithelium, that means the cilia is present and that cilia will help in the movement mechanism. So, how this can happen? In this case, the correct option you have is second, that is the bronchioles and fallopian tube. Right, students, note this down. I'll be back. Now, students, let's move on to the next question. So, this is question number 75. So, which of the following statement is correct? So, we have to look for a correct statement. Now, the four options which are given are: cornea is convex transparent layer which is highly vascularized. No, it is not at all vascularized. That is the reason behind the survival of this cornea transplantation. So, cornea consists of a dense matrix of collagen and it is the most sensitive portion of eye. No, this is also incorrect. The cornea is external, transparent and protective proteinaceous covering of eyeball. Yes, for the question number 75, the correct option we have is 3. Let's move on to the next question, question number 76. Now, this question is also direct from the NCRT. That's the reason I'm not going into detail. Drug called heroin is synthesized from, we know that this heroin is synthesized from morphine and they are formed because of the acetylation procedure. So, by the acetylation of the morphine we get is a heroin. So, I'll go for an option 4 in this case, right? Let's move on to the next question, question number 77. Now, under which of the following condition will there will be no change in the reading frame of the following mRNA sequence? So, they have given one mRNA sequence starting from a 5 prime end to a 3 prime end and we have to check whether there will be change in the reading frame or not if following mutation or following changes occur within this sequence. Now, please look at this sequence very carefully. These are termed as a codon, the triplet codon, and each codon they normally code for a one specific amino acid, this we know. Whenever we talk about a particular knockout, a particular addition, in that case a reading frame will shift. Insertion of A and G are the fourth and the fifth position respectively. See, these are the first three codon at the fourth position and the fifth position I have inserted two nucleotide, adenine and guanine. So, two are added. So, this is quite obvious that two along with this one A that will called as or that will constitute one particular codon. So, there will be shifting in the reading frame and shifting will be like this. Now, these GCG will be read as another codon. Now, again there will be shift like this and similarly the shift will going to happen. So, in the first option shift will happen. Deletion of GGU from the 7th and 8th and 9th position. Now, first option we have discarded. Now, GGU if the whole the 3 triplet codon we have knocked out. In that case, after this particular codon, we will read this codon. So, there will be no shift in the codon, no shift in the reading frame. So, this option is right. Now, insertion of a G at a fifth position, we are inserting one nucleotide at one position. So, definite is quite definite because it is not occurring in the multiple of 3. So, there will be change in the reading frame. And the last option also deletion, if the deletion is happening, whether the insertion or deletion is happening, there will be shift until unless that is in the multiple of 3. So, I'll go for an option 2 for the question 77. Let's move on to the next question, question number 78. Now, which of the following is true for the golden rice? Now, this question is from the chapter biotechnology applications, golden rice. Golden rice we know that is a recombinant variety which we have produced by the introduction of a foreign gene and that foreign gene is for the beta carotene which is a precursor of vitamin A. The options are it is a drought tolerant, no it is not a drought tolerant, instead we have added some properties in it and it has a golden color, that is why the name is given as a golden rice. So, first option is incorrect, second it has a yellow grains because of the gene introduced from a primitive variety of rice. Is it right or wrong? This is wrong. C, vitamin A enriched with a gene from the daffodil, yes this option is correct. So, we will go for a third option. Let's move on to the next question, question number 79. Now, the ciliated epithelium cells are required to move the particles or the mucus in a specific direction. In human, these cells are mainly present in. So, in this case, I'll go for an option bronchioles in the fallopian tube. In bronchioles, the ciliated epithelium is present, and this ciliated epithelium help in the removal of the pathogen. That can be any microbe, and in the removal of the mucus, because it acts like a, you can say, we are sweeping something. Now, next is a fallopian tube. As per the female reproductive system, is considered the fallopian tube lining that is also ciliated. Because once egg is synthesized in the oocyte is synthesized in the ovary, that will move towards the fallopian tube, and there is one particular region which we call it as an ampullary isthmic region, the where fertilization occurs. So egg or the oocyte has to travel this much of distance. How do they travel? Because of the ciliary action of the fallopian tube. So I'll go for an option 2 in this case. Let's move on to the next question, question number 80. Now, phloem in gymnosperm, this is also again a direct question from NCERT. This exception is mentioned in the chapter, the anatomy of the flowering plants. The phloem in the gymnosperm, they do not have the sieve tube cells and the companion cells. These both cells, they are absent in them, right? So this was a question number 80. Let's move on. Instead, they have albuminous cells present in them. Let's move on to the next question, question number 81. Now, the grass leaves curl inward during very dry weather. Select the most appropriate region from the following. A, shrinkage of the air spaces in the spongy mesophyll, tylosis in the vessels, closure of the stomata, the flaccidity of the bulliform cells. So, I'll go for an option 4, that is a bulliform cells. These bulliform cells, once they lose water, and when they lose water, they become flaccid in nature, due to which the leaf, or you can say this grass, curls. Whenever they become turgid, they become straight. So, which option is correct? The fourth option is correct for this question. Let's move on to the next question, question number 82. Now, tidal volume and expiratory reserve volume of an athlete is 500 ml and the 1000 ml respectively. What will be the expiratory capacity if the residual volume is 1200 ml? Again, a direct question. As I have discussed, that capacities, all these capacities, they are very important in your respiration chapter, breathing and exchange of gases. Now, to talk about the expiratory capacity is the addition of the tidal volume as well as the expiratory reserve volume. So, what should be the answer? It should be the 1500 ml. So, I will go for an option 3 in this case. Hope here this question is also right. Now, let's move on to the next question, question number 83. Now, this question is from the chapter Structural Organization in Animals, in which we have discussed the anatomy of cockroach. Now, we have to select a correct sequence. We have to look for a correct sequence organs in the alimentary canal of the cockroach, starting from the mouth region. So, to start with the uppermost region, they have the mouth parts are present. In that mouth part, the first region they have is the presence of the pharynx, right? After that, the pharynx, after pharynx, they have the presence of the esophagus. After esophagus, one glandular structure is present, which we call it as a crop. After crop, the gizzard is present. After the gizzard, we have is another part which is called as a ileum, colon and rectum, right, which is a part of the large intestine. So, I will go for an option C in this case, the pharynx, esophagus, the crop, gizzard, ileum, colon and rectum. So, option C is correct for this. Right? Is it fine? So, this was also one of the, you can say, the easiest question. Now, let's move on to the next question, question number 84. So, this question was bit, I can say, this is a moderate type of question. Now, I have to look for an incorrect statement. Many times I have discussed such type of question in our crash course as well as a NEET pattern question exercise. Now, inbreeding selects harmful recessive gene that reduces the fertility and productivity. Now, inbreeding, which yes, we go for an inbreeding procedure, but it doesn't select it, that occurs randomly, and that we call it as an inbreeding depression. So, this option is incorrect, and we are looking for an incorrect statement only. I will go for an option 1, but definitely, it is quite definite that I will read other options also. Second, inbreeding help in accumulation of the superior gene. Yes, homozygosity it occurs, and elimination of the undesirable genes. Inbreeding increases the homozygosity. Yes, this is also correct. Inbreeding is essential to evolve the pure line of any animals. Yes, for the pure line also, because we want homozygosity. So, in that case, we go for a continuous inbreeding mechanisms. So, I will go for an option 1 for the question number 84. Let's move on to the next question, question number 85. Now this is a second same question. Earlier it was asked in some other form, now it is asked in another form. So two questions, they are similar. Select the correct group of biocontrol agents. Biocontrol agents, they are those which actually control other pathogen causing any kind of disease. So the four options are given. In this case, I'll go for an option to trichoderma. This was other part, this was a part. Baculovirus and Bacillus thuringiensis, right? So which option is correct? The fourth one, right? Let's move on to the next question, question number 86. Thiobacillus is a group of bacteria helpful in carrying out. So hope you remember that cycle, the nitrogen cycle. Thiobacillus, it is clearly mentioned in your NCRT, again another direct question from NCRT. So in this case, the thiobacillus, they help in the process of denitrification. Examples, we have discussed regarding the denitrification, the nitrification process. So I'll go for an option 2 in this case. Let's move on to the next question, question number 87. Another question from the chapter Anatomy of Flowering Plants. Which of the statement given below is not true about the formation of annual rings? So we have to look for a not true or the incorrect statement, right? Now the four options, the first is activity of cambium, they depend upon the variation in climate. Yes, this is obvious. So it helps in the secondary growth. So cambium is important and it actually varies according to the temperature. Annual rings are not prominent in the tree of the temperate region. This statement is completely incorrect. Because in the temperate region, when the temperature is high, at that time there will be, you can say, the dense formation of this annual rings as compared to those plants growing in the tropical region. So this option is incorrect. Let's look at the three also. Option three, annual rings is a combination of spring wood and the autumn wood produced in a year. Yes, both the rings, the spring, that one particular ring and another ring, we count it as a one. So this is also right. We are looking for an incorrect statement. Differential activity of cambium causes a light and the dark band of the tissue, early and the late wood respectively. Yes, this is also correct. So for the question 87, I'll go for an option 2. Let's move on to the next question, question number 88. It takes very long time for the pineapple plants to produce flowers. Which combination of the hormone can be applied artificially to induce flowering in the pineapple plants throughout the year to increase the yield? Now, plant growth and development, the chapter in which we have discussed regarding the different hormones. This is also a direct question that is already mentioned in the textbook. So in this case, I'll go for an option 3, that is auxin and gibberellin. In case of the auxin, specifically the application of NAA, that is a naphthalene acetic acid, their application as well as the ethylene application that leads to the flowering, right? Question number 88. Now let's move on to the next question, question number 89. Polyblend, a fine powder of the recycled modified plastic, has proved to be a great material for the construction of road. Again, the first option is correct. And this whole experiment, this whole revolutionary work was done by the Ahmed Khan. So for this, I'll go for an option 1. Let's move on to the next question, question number 9090. The shorter and the longer arm of a submetacentric chromosome are referred as. Now listen very carefully. Submetacentric. Right? In this case, the centromere is little bit shifted to one of the end. Little bit shifted. It is not present in the center. If it is present in the center, then it will be, if it is present in the center, we call such type of chromosome as a metacentric. So it is little deviated from the center. So one arm, the short arm called as a P arm, and second is called as a Q arm. Right? So we have the shorter will be called as a P arm and the Q arm respectively. So I'll go for an option 4. So with this, we have completed the out of the 90 question, the half question, 45 we have completed.